Good morning. I'm at one of my favourite stations in London, that is London St Pancras, through which Thameslink passes through, and that is what we're here to talk about today, because after 22 years of not being on the tube map, Thameslink is making a return. Here's the history.
Thameslink opened in 1988, but it actually first appeared on the 1987 tube map in yellow to promote that it was opening soon. It showed the core section only between Kentish Town and Elephant and Castle, even though trains ran further. Note also that the Thameslink trains also called at Barbican and Moorgate then, and that the map also showed the Northern City Line, which had once been part of the Northern Line, the section between Moorgate and Finsbury Park. Throughout most of the 1990s, Thameslink remained on the tube map, and so it was for 10 years.
So I dug out my old box of tube maps. This is the one from December 1998, exactly 22 years ago. And if you look inside, you can see that it is the last one that has Thameslink as a white line running through the middle. It was shortly after this time, though, that Transport for London was formed.
By the next edition, in June 1999, Thameslink had gone, and so intriguingly had the North London Line, which had also been on the tube map for many years. The next year, though, was 2000, and that's when Transport for London was formed, and in the first new tube map of that year, the North London Line reappeared. This would, of course, later be transformed under TfL into the London Overground. Thameslink, though, never came back to the map.
That is until now. Yes, 22 years later, Thameslink really is back on the December 20 tube map. To find out why, I caught up with Tom, the managing director of Thameslink.
So we've wanted to be on the tube map for many years, but I think in the last few months, particularly with COVID and the need to socially distance, we've had some really, really helpful conversations, really constructive conversations with TfL. I think London Travel Watch have also been very helpful. They've raised the need for it and been very supportive. So what that's led to is kind of more detailed discussions, and now we've got to where we are now. We just think it's such good news for our customers, for everyone in London, that Thameslink is going to be on the tube map. It means that everyone, whether they're visiting London or coming into work, can see where our trains will take you and get there as easily and safely as possible. It is for 12 months, it is going to be reviewed, and I suppose we'll see where we get to. What I would say, though, is that I think people will really see the benefit of having TL services on the tube map, because it just gives them as many options as possible, and they know the quickest and simplest way to get where they need to get to.
So when I heard that Thameslink was coming back to the tube map, I assumed it would just be the central core section again, from Kentish Town down to Elephant and Castle and London Bridge. But no, it's more than that. It's generally everything within side Zone 6. It includes the Sutton Loop, goes up to Elstree, down to Coulsdon. Out east, in the southeast, it does also go to Dartford and Swanley, which are in Zone 8. And with all these new stops on the tube map, it's got me counting exactly how many stations are now on the new tube map.
So if you include the Underground, Overground, Wombling Free, DLR, Trams and TfL Rail, there were previously 460 stops on the tube map, but the addition of Thameslink has now added 49 new ones to give us a grand total of 509 stations on the new map. And that now means that 47% of the tube map isn't actually tube. 10% of it isn't even TfL, but 247 of them, that's 49%, are shown as being step-free.
Which for me makes it feel like it's just one step towards the tube map becoming a little bit like the London Rail and Tube map. How long is it going to be before these two products are maybe merged and we just have one map? And here's some design thoughts about this map.
When you look at that, you realise that it's on there that London's rail service are actually shown as dashed lines, which is probably why on the new tube map they've replicated that style to show Thameslink. Note though, that they're using quite long dashes, whereas the dashes to denote a limited service to Ken Olympia are much shorter. Also, they've used a shade of pink that looks quite close to being, but isn't actually the same shade as on the Hammersmith and City line, and it's definitely a different RGB value to the shade of pink that Thameslink use in their logo.
Other things that caught my eye is that Blackfriars, which has a Thameslink entrance on either side as the station spans the river, the blob on the tube map is just on the south side. Look down at Heathrow, there are no trains stopping at Heathrow Terminal 4 at the moment, so that is crossed out, red line through that, and also there's no service on the Waterloo and City line, hasn't been since March because of COVID, and so that is also marked as being closed.
And another thing that caught my attention is now how close Herne Hill, Tulse Hill and Streatham are bunched up together. And I can't help but wonder that it could have looked less squashed by simply angling up the border of Zone 2 underneath Brixton, which would have allowed more space to space those three stations out.
But I am, in case you hadn't realised, so excited to have Thameslink on the tube map. On screen now are the figures of how many trains you get passing through. In some cases, it's more frequent than what you get on some parts of the tube. I'm really excited, but I'm so excited interested, I'm going to take a quick trip now on the course section and show you a few of my favourite connections. The first one is right here where I've been filming. If you come out the side, that's the western entrance to St Pancras, which is where Thameslink is anyway, you can cut through the back streets and back alleys to get to Euston. St Pancras Thameslink is a really handy and fast way to get to Euston. Here at Farringdon, possibly the fastest connection you can make between the Tube and Thameslink, get up the third carriage, come down these steps, and the westbound platform of the Tube is adjacent to this, the southbound platform of Thameslink. So fast. So there's a new dotted line walking connection on the new Tube map between here, City Thameslink, and the Central Line station St Paul's just down the way. But City Thameslink has two entrances, one at the south end, one at the north end. For St Paul's, make sure you get out here at the north end. And number four is I've come to Blackfriars, and actually I just like using Blackfriars because it's awesome. Where else in London do you get a railway station that spans the Thames? There's an entrance on both sides. I've come to the southern side. It is actually quite nice though to get an amazing view when you step on or off a Thameslink train over the Thames. There are also two bay platforms here, and in the morning some southeastern services terminate here, and rather than get onto the crush that is the Tube, you can then hop onto a Thameslink to take you into the city in Farringdon and into Zone 1 and so on that way. And that is why Blackfriars is awesome. And now, a quick summing up. And so, to summarise, it's like having a brand new Tube line on the new map. The designers have done a great job of fitting it all in, by the way, I think. Going right through the heart of Zone 1. Remember, 12-car trains, they've got toilets, you can use an Oyster to pay the same fares as you can do with other Tube services. Think of it as a brand new Tube line to London. It's fantastic. I do love Thameslink. I'm very excited about the new December 20 Tube map as well. Thanks for watching. If you've enjoyed this video and you've never watched before, press subscribe, check out all my videos and playlists, loads more like this. Thanks a lot.